Phi Beta Kappa at 14, first in your law school class at 17. I'd say any law firm would be lucky to get you, David, in 5 years.
But you can be 18 and practice law in the state of California. Not hiring me because of my age would be discrimination. Not that I'm accusing you.
David, you're a decade younger than our new lawyers. In fact, you're younger than most of our bike messengers.
Well, actually, sir, I think my age is a plus. It gives me time to become what I want to be.
And what is that?
A trial lawyer.
Oh. Oh, Tom Cruise in A Few Good Men. Clarence Darrow, that sort of thing?
Well, sir, when you look at it historically, every great cause in this country was fought by trial lawyers. Every great injustice was fixed by them. So if you want to do something with your law degree, if you really want to make a difference in people's lives, then you have to be a trial lawyer.
Excuse me, sir. There's a woman here asking for Skip.
Nickname? Because I skipped so many grades, not because I skip.
The woman is my mother. She's driving me home.
No, I can drive. My car's used. It's in the shop. I'm currently saving up money to get a new one. And my own apartment. So.
I'm Grant Cooper, your court-appointed attorney. So tell me about this guy. Did he attack you? Yes? No? Maybe? All right. So it wasn't self-defense. It was something that just happened. Her confession. Murder, second degree. I promised her 15 years. You're welcome.
Who's the DA?
Grant Cooper. He's not the DA. He's her defense lawyer.
So another law firm didn't hire you. Big deal. You need to chill. Take some time off. Let people catch up with you.
Hey, you know, you're so smart, Tom, yet somehow you managed to fail 10th grade.
Dude, failing 10th grade was the smartest thing I ever did. Because now, Mom and Dad will be happy if I just graduate.
You are, sir.
How far down am I, Skip?
50 a stroke. You got 2-to-1 odds on the back nine, so $735. It's easy. You lost every hole.
Fine. Thank you. Okay, gentlemen.
Double or nothing.
Is he hustling us, or is he just desperate?
No, he's not hustling.
Got a good feeling about this, Skip.
Very good.
Hello?
Hello. Ah, that makes yours good.
Hey, if I don't help him hustle, you don't get paid. I swear to God, dude, I didn't think he'd sink it this time.
When I'm up with the sunrise, I want more than just a blue skies. I want more.
Great lawyers don't wait for breaks, Skip.
Sometimes you just gotta make your own luck. Thanks for the help, boys.
You know her?
Not yet.
She went to my law school. She's a lawyer now.
Any luck with the job yet? Why don't you let me throw you some more work? The insurance company in the Smith case, they just filed their summary judgment motion. You could write my response.
You told me Smith was settling.
It will settle. It just hasn't. And it won't if I lose summary judgment.
Why don't you just write the thing yourself?
I'm not a paper kind of guy.
Grant, I caddy for you. I know you. Don't hustle me.
I'm making you a legitimate offer. You write the Smith brief, help me out with a few civil cases, and I will have you in court Monday morning. Now, no downtown law firm's gonna do that for you.
Are you sure he's the right lawyer to start your career with? You did say Mr. Cooper drinks.
Well, not all the time, Mom. Plus, no one else would hire him. He's too young. Dude shouldn't have skipped so many grades.
Deborah, I think we should just be happy that Skip finally got hired. And he said that Mr. Cooper would be getting him right into court.
In exchange for David staying up all night writing a brief. I'm not being critical, David. It's your choice. I hate parents who push their kids. We never did that. I just don't see how working for an ambulance chaser is the best use of your skills.
Cooper is not an ambulance chaser, Mom. He represents criminals, too.
Thanks for that.
All right, read them, plead them, and move them out. These are all court appointments. Poor, so they can't afford a real defense, which is all right, because they're all guilty anyway. Here she comes. You know her?
No, I don't. I don't tend to meet women like that.
Well, she seems nice. She did stab a guy to death, though. Paradise. Meet Skip Ross.
David, actually. It's very nice to meet you. You can practice law at 18 in the state of California. You can in several states. For example, Idaho.
Great, Skip. Thanks. I think she got it. Now look, you're all set. The DA took the deal. All you have to do is plead guilty.
Can we talk first?
We could talk. Or not.
Now look, this should go pretty quick in here, but if anything bad happens, just get a continuance.
Whoa, why would anything bad happen?
This judge hates me.
187B, second degree murder. She faces 15 years to life. Trial's today, but we reached an agreement.
Grant Cooper for the defense.
Why? I ordered you not to come back without a second chair. I'm tired of you coming in here unprepared.
She ordered you to have help. Judge Abrahams, allow me to introduce Mr. Skip Ross, Esquire.
It's David, actually.
Mr. Ross graduated number one in his class, and he is now my second chair.
Well, with his smarts, I think he should be first chair, don't you? You know what, Mr. Ross, in my discretion, I am directing you to act as first chair.
Your Honor, I would like a continuance.
No, you would move for a continuance, and I would deny it.
This isn't going very well. Look, just run her through the damn place so we can get the hell out of here.
Hi there.
Hi there.
So, I'm gonna handle your guilty plea. Is that okay?
Okay. But I was trying to tell Mr. Cooper, I'm not guilty. I didn't kill anyone.
What's going on?
Mr. Ross, I am very busy. There are other cases stacking up behind you. May we proceed?
Come on. Your Honor, we're not pleading guilty. Apparently, she didn't do it. So I am sorry.
All we had to do was stand there. The judge would have taken the plea.
No, not if you were standing there alone, Grant. You were ordered to have co-counsel. You remember that?
Okay. Are you from around here? Well, where did you go to school?
Hermosa Beach.
Oh, we used to run against Hermosa Beach, cross country. I actually lettered JV, but, you know, big deal. Everybody letters in high school cross country.
Could you please just talk to her about the murder? We have another client back at the office.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, Kim was throwing a party.
Kim?
Kim's a guy. My luck, I got to the house just before the cops raided. Everyone ran out but me, and stupid girl, I went looking for Kim.
Why?
I love him. So I checked the bedroom. And I saw the dead guy. He was a dealer. He was Kem's competition. I mean, they hated each other, and it was Kem's knife, so I took it.
Why would you do that?
I just told you, I love him. I want to keep him out of trouble. Like with his burglary that I pled to last year, I was trying to keep him out of prison. But since I got here, he hasn't come to see me. Not once. I didn't murder that guy. Kem did.
She's lying. She killed the guy.
But she seems innocent to me. Illogical, maybe, but innocent.
She's not illogical. She's dumb. Cops only catch the dumb ones.
But if she was lying, she'd come up with a better story, wouldn't she? No, I know, I know. Occam's razor, philosophical precept. As the two explanations, the simplest one is always true. But
stop talking. They caught her with the murder weapon, and she confessed. Now, which part of that makes you think she's innocent?
The part when she said, I didn't murder that guy, Kem did.
Ah, she just pissed off because her boyfriend ditched her. She pleads guilty, she gets 15 years. If she loses a trial, she goes down for life. So she pleads guilty, period.
But how could you plead her guilty without reading the reports first?
Skip, I'm talking to Mrs. Smith. We are not going to lose summary judgment.
I'm sorry, but there's just one report from Detective Walsh. No crime scene photos.
Yeah, I still have to pick those up. Now, sorry. We were talking about...
Is this your whole file on Paradise?
Skip, look! You promised me big money, Mr. Cooper. If I don't get it, I'll sue you for malpractice.
The Smith brief is so good, they'll increase their settlement offer. I promise. In return, just get me all the reports on Paradise and go with me to talk to this Kem guy.
Why would we do that? Because she's pretty? You want to save her?
No, because she's our client. We have to gather evidence for her trial.
But we're not going to trial. We're going to plead her guilty at 2.
Well, then we need to gather evidence we can use at her sentencing after she pleads. Under her deal, 15 is the most she could get, right? Maybe we could convince the judge to give her less.
Are you hustling me? Good for you. But that brief better be damn good.
I could get 10 grand from the bank if one of these guys would crack a rib.
Hey, any of you guys been hurt out there? Listen, I'm gonna leave a stack of cards with the kid here. Llame si habla español. Me gano para usted.
Ren, I think they're Samoans.
Let me do the talking, all right?
Paradise is stand up, no doubt. I can't help her. My card's full.
Why didn't you visit her in jail?
She doesn't want me anywhere near her case. Believe me.
Why? Where were you the night the police raided the house?
Where does Paradise say I was?
Take it easy. She hasn't said anything. Skip, let's go.
Were you ever convicted of any violent crimes?
Just because a question is relevant doesn't mean you have to ask it.
How do we create reasonable doubt for her if we don't ask questions?
We don't. We plead her out, just like all our other criminal cases. Even if she had a defense, she couldn't pay for it. She can't afford experts and lab tests. She's a loser. A loser boyfriend and a loser case.
She's poor. She's made some bad boyfriend choices, but that doesn't mean she's a killer. Plus, Kem had a motive. The dead man was once arrested for trying to shoot Kem.
Says who?
It was in the case file. Didn't you even read it?
I don't need to read it. She's lucky to have this deal. And she's taking it.
Please, ma'am, one more time. Paradise Colvin, I have the lawyer's discovery. I just need the police reports. Okay. Come on, please. Just do me this favor and then somehow later I'll do you a favor.
Are you coming on to me, boy?
Paradise Colvin's my case. I'm Detective Walsh. I figure if you took the job, you must not know much about Cooper. Can he tell you about our deal? Guess not. Cooper used to be a great trial lawyer, but with a big ego.
Trial lawyers tend to have big egos.
Maybe it was more than ego. Hubris. Is that a word? Hubris?
Sure. Hubris. Excessive pride, self-confidence, arrogance.
You're not old enough to remember Leonard Debs, are you? They said he killed a cop. This was back before Rodney King and OJ, when folks still respected cops. No lawyer would defend Debs, so Cooper volunteered on principle.
That's admirable, isn't it?
No, son. That's hubris. Cooper fought hard, too. He even proved that the cops beat a confession out of Debs. I warned him not to make waves. See, in this business, kid, you gotta go along to get along. Cops, judges.
But he won the trial, right?
No. Debs was convicted. Cooper could have pled Debs to life, but he didn't. And Debs got the needle, lethal injection, executed 1991. System got even with Cooper. Cop said he tried to bribe a witness. He didn't do it, but you know, by the time they cleared him, no lawyer will go anywhere near him. You know, if it wasn't for me, poor guy would probably starve to death.
I'm sorry, I never knew any of that. Thank you for telling me. This is for you. It's a subpoena. I'm calling you to testify in the Colvin case. We're going to trial.
So if you lose, what? The executor?
Would you please stop asking me that?
What the hell are those?
Paradise's mother brought them.
Maybe we can use them to humanize her, you know, in front of the jury.
I read it. Criminal procedure.
What's your case theory?
The boyfriend, Kim, did it.
Self-defense would be better.
But there's no evidence to support that. She never said she was attacked.
All right, suit yourself. Go with Kim. Classic SOD.
Excuse me?
Some other dude did it. It's part of the class of dude defenses. Some dude made me do it. Some other dude did it. Or dude, I did it, but you just can't prove it.
Yeah, that's the one. Dude, I did it, you just can't prove it. Right?
The knife plunged underneath the sternum, pushed into the chest cavity, and to reach just below the heart.
That girl at the back, that's your sister?
Yeah. Mom won't come.
And this was the murder weapon, Doctor?
Definitely so.
Your witness.
Where are you going?
To cross-examine the coroner.
Why? Is the victim not dead? All right. Just hit for the middle of the fairway. Nothing fancy.
Okay. Now, sir, you don't know how the fatal wound was inflicted in this case. No, I know, the knife. I mean, you don't know exactly how it ended up in the victim's chest.
I don't know that. I wasn't there.
I want the doctor to demonstrate the angle of the knife blow for the jury. Your Honor, how would I do that?
Doctor, please step down from the witness stand and face the jury. A pencil will represent the knife. Mr. Ross will play the victim.
We don't have cameras here. You need to describe verbally what you're doing for the court reporter.
Okay. The coroner is facing me. I'm the victim. He's the killer. The killer takes the knife back and with a sweeping upward motion swings the knife into the victim's stomach.
Let the record reflect that the coroner has demonstrated an upward thrust with the knife as if coming from below the victim. Will there be anything else, Mr. Ross?
No.
Good call not using the knife.
Still planning to call me to testify? Is you ready to quit?
Sorry, Jimmy. This guy doesn't know how to quit.
Look, I don't testify, ever. It's insulting. Tell him not to put me on the stand.
Telling this kid not to do something just makes him want to do it more. A real pesky son of a bitch.
I hear you're, taking the Smith case to trial? The car crash I sent you?
No. The insurance company is lowballing me. I'm bluffing the trial so I can jack up the settlement offer.
You think you'll scare them with your record? You haven't won a jury trial in years. Hell, you haven't had a jury trial in years.
Well, maybe I'm due. Don't worry about it. Smith will settle. I'm never going to trial again.
Got a good deal here. Don't blow it. When this is over, I want you to fire that little bastard.
Don't you ever sleep? We're pulling out of the Coleman case.
That's a joke, right? I'm not quitting on my first case.
Well, you can do what you want, but you've lost your second chair.
What the hell is wrong with you? You never got the case reports. You never read her file. You never even checked to see if she had a defense. Justice is supposed to be blind, Grant, not the attorneys.
Don't you lecture me. Damn you. My God, it must be a pain in the ass to be right all the time.
Actually, it's horrible. People always think you're a know-it-all, and women are definitely not impressed.
I was being sarcastic.
I know, but she's our client. She's depending on us. We're supposed to fight for her. Like you did for Leonard Debs.
I learned a lot in the Debs case. I learned to stop looking for fights. You can't beat them, Skip. The judges and the cops, they'll crush you. Don't go after Detective Walsh.
What does that mean?
Do what you want to do, but I'm out. No good to you anyway.
Mr. Ross, does the defense intend to call a witness or not?
We call Detective Walsh to the stand. So you were the detective responsible for this case?
I was the supervisory detective.
Oh, so then you're the one who failed to order fingerprint or DNA testing.
What should we have tested exactly?
The body? The knife? The crime scene?
We don't do tests if we don't have to, Counselor. They're expensive, and we didn't need them.
Your client was caught holding the murder weapon. There was no mystery here.
There was no mystery here? When I cross-examined the coroner, he demonstrated how the knife wound came upwards from below the victim.
Yeah, I saw him stab you. How are you feeling now?
Just fine, thank you. So the dead man's blood would have flowed down. The killer would have gotten blood on his hands and clothes. But there was no blood found in either my client's clothes or hands. That's kind of mysterious, isn't it?
Maybe the guy didn't start bleeding right away, or maybe your client moves fast.
She was the slowest person in the house. When you raided, everyone else ran out, didn't they? Any one of them might have committed this murder.
But only one of them did, the one who confessed, your client.
She confessed to protect someone.
Who? Who was she protecting?
Do you know a man named Kem Hunt?
Objection.
I have a witness who will testify under oath in support of our defense.
Well, you better. Overruled.
I don't recall knowing him.
Kem Hunt is a violent felon and known rival of the dead man.
Really? Says who?
Well, actually, sir, you do. Those are your crime reports. You arrested Kem Hunt twice in the past. How are you feeling now?
We were talking. You got a problem?
But you told me he did.
Yeah, but Kem didn't kill him.
Paradise, as your lawyer, I can't let you get on the stand now and lie to protect him. He isn't even worth it anyway.
How do you know? You don't know anything.
I know you didn't kill anyone. With the lack of blood and the bad police investigation, we might have a shot at reasonable doubt. But if you don't get on the stand and say that Kem did it, we're dead.
I'm not gonna say Kem did it.
You heard me tell the judge that I have a witness who will say it was Kem. You're that witness.
No, you don't get it. You're gonna have to come up with something else, all right?
You're back?
Yeah. Sorry. Bugging out on you mid-trial like that.
Kem got to Paradise. She wanted to see him. I couldn't stop it.
What the hell with what she wants? You're the lawyer. You should have kicked his ass out of there.
That really wasn't an option.
Well, then you should have made him kick your ass and gotten him arrested. What the hell do they teach you guys in law school nowadays?
Well, should we put her on the stand anyway?
To say what?
That she's innocent.
What is that going to get you? How does she explain the bloody knife in her confession?
I don't know. But if she testifies, they'll see she's telling the truth, right? That should matter, right? Please tell me what to do.
You wanted to try cases? You got to make these calls. That's why most of us give up trials.
Did you see who committed this murder?
No. I don't know who did it. I took the knife out of the dead man and hid. But I didn't kill him. And I lied when I said I did.
Do you know a man named Kem Hunt?
Kem's my friend.
Well, actually, you told me you loved Kem. And that he committed this murder.
Objection. Mr. Ross is not a witness.
Sustained. The jury will disregard. Watch it, Mr. Ross.
Kem Hunt visited you today, didn't he?
Yes. But he didn't threaten me. And the truth is, Kem didn't kill the guy.
Wait. I'm sorry, but I thought you just told us you didn't know who killed him. No further questions.
Miss Colvin, do you remember that night, clearly?
Yes.
What were you wearing?
What I had on when I was arrested.
Do you recognize this? We found it next to the dead man.
Objection. I never saw that jacket. This evidence was never given to us.
Yes, it was. Check your evidence list.
Sit down, Mr. Ross.
Whose jacket is it, Miss Colvin?
It's mine. I wore it that night.
Move that the witness try on the jacket. Now, in front of the jury.
On what grounds?
Your Honor, my client is mistaken. It's not her jacket. And if it doesn't fit, then the jury must...
No, sir, don't you dare finish that.
Your Honor, I need her to do it.
She just said that it's her jacket. There's no reason for her to try it on. Sit down, Mr. Ross. Motion denied.
But, Your Honor...
Sit down, Mr. Ross, or I will have the deputy take you down.
I never should have put her on the stand. Plus, I saw a jean jacket on the evidence list, but I thought it was a man's. The victim's, not hers.
It's all right. You did enough.
I did? You think I'm gonna win?
No. She's gonna get convicted. But you didn't quit. That's something. A man does not only fight to win. Better to fight in vain. Boss just handed that to me. Kim's alibi. Two guys confirm it.
He's lying. They're lying.
Probably. Why ask her to try on the jacket?
Because it won't fit. It's not hers.
Paradise didn't do it. I don't care. Well, you gotta do something. Get a mistrial or keep investigating or... We made an innocent girl confess.
You did. And when did you get religion? You know, for years, you've been living off of me, off of cases I send you.
It wasn't out of the goodness of your heart, Jimmy.
It's a fair deal. You plead out criminal cases, I send you car crashes. I go home with wins, you go home with money.
Except that this client isn't guilty.
Do you really think she's the only innocent one you helped send away? Oh, man. That's rich.
We're not on the same side anymore. We're not supposed to be.
That's not your jacket.
How long have you known it was your sister?
When Kim visited me.
When the police raided, you went looking for your sister, not Kim.
I never should have told Susan about that party. She came and got drunk and was messing with the guy. She wanted him to stop. He got rough. Very rough. She grabbed the knife. She was trying to protect herself. She accidentally killed him.
You have to tell the police before I give the closing and it's too late.
No.
She's gonna bury you.
I'm not gonna snitch on my sister, Skip. I love her. She's a chance to do something with her life. I mean, she's going to college.
What you could do? You're very smart. And you're loyal. You are a fine person. Don't you know that?
Look, I can't let you get convicted.
Could you come up with something else? Please.
I will.
Mr. Ross?
Grant.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, Mr. Ross is no trial lawyer, not yet. But even he proved reasonable doubt in this case. The knife that went up into the chest, but there was no blood on our client or her clothes. The house was full of gangbangers, and yet the police didn't even bother to look for another suspect. The violent boyfriend sees her before she testifies, and suddenly she won't say that he is the killer. No, Mr. Ross is no Johnny Cochran. But he did enough. None of the other professionals in this room even looked for the truth. And now, the only hope that our client has is that you will. You saw her testify. If you believed her, then you must acquit her. The truth is that a liar would have come up with a better story. The truth isn't always logical, but it is the truth. And in law, the truth is the only thing that's supposed to matter. But so often, the law lets us down. The rich get away with murder. The poor suffer. My God, you practice law long enough, it breaks your heart. But you know, even in all of that, the law is still the best thing that people have come up with to do good. But for the law to work, for the law to matter, a lawyer has to take it up. He has to use it. He has to fight. I didn't. Shame on me. Justice is supposed to be blind, not the attorneys.
What happened to your hand?
Oh, I settled something out of court.
The Smith case?
Oh, no. That goes to trial tomorrow. I have to pull the trial exhibits together by 8 a.m.
Oh. Un homme ne se bat pas toujours pour gagner. Mieux vaut se battre en vain. A man does not always fight to win. Better to fight in vain. It's Edmond Rostand from Cyrano de Bergerac.
It is? I thought I made it up.
I'll help you with the exhibits.
Don't bother. Should have started on it months ago.
Well, then why didn't you? Why don't we start trying to win?
Has the jury reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
As to the charge of murder in the second degree, how say you?
We, the jury, find the defendant, Paradise Colvin, not guilty.
The jury is excused.
I don't believe that.
Congratulations, Ms. Colvin. I now find you guilty.
Of what?
She was on probation at the time of her arrest. I find her guilty of violating that probation by hiding a murder weapon and giving a false confession. I'm sentencing her to 10 years in prison. Suspended with stayaways and weekly reporting to probation through her lawyers. We're adjourned.
I'll see you later, Grant.
Where are you going?
Just back up to the office. I want to start work on Paradise's sentencing appeal.
What sentencing appeal?
Skip! She doesn't have a sentencing appeal. We're not appealing her sentence.
Cause it's a good life, so why y'all tripping? The good vibes slipping away. It's a good life, so why y'all tripping? The good vibes slipping away. Yeah, it's a good life, so why y'all tripping? The good vibes slipping away. It's a good life, so why y'all tripping? The good vibes slipping away. Come on, y'all.